क्लास 8 ऑफ पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स फॉर डिप्लोमा केपीटी स्टूडेंट्स. मेथड्स ऑफ टर्निंग ऑन ऑफ एन एससीआर. देर आर 5 मेथड्स: फॉरवर्ड, वोल्टेज ट्रिगरिंग, गेट ट्रिगरिंग, दिस. सो फर्स्ट इज फॉरवर्ड वोल्टेज ट्रिगरिंग. वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड when gate is open, if the applied forward voltage is more than or crosses its forward breakover voltage, the SCR fires. So this is one method, but we don't use that method because it is risky. Second one, gate triggering. When the forward voltage is lesser than breakover voltage, when you give a gate current, the SCR will go to on state. This is called as gate triggering. You have different types there once again: DC gate triggering, etc., etc. We will study it later. Third one is dV by dt triggering. Here what we will do is, what happens is, actually we do not do that, it happens. If the rate of rise of forward voltage is very high, sometimes what happens is, say, this is the circuit. You switch on this. Suppose, say, you apply the main voltage. There is no gate, say, assume that there is no gate. Main voltage you are closing here. Say this is 230 volts or 500 volts. When you close this, there is suddenly 230 volts is being applied across these two points. These two are ready for conduction, J1 and J3. Now what happens is, the leakage current will flow. You know that these junctions will act as capacitance. See, this is not conducting. So this is like a dielectric. These and these are ready to conduct. You know, two conducting plates separated by dielectric is a capacitor. This is a capacitor. So this acts as top plate, this acts as bottom plate, and this junction acts as this dielectric. So when you suddenly apply this voltage because of sudden switching, what happens is, the leakage current which charges the capacitor will become very high. See, you know Q is equal to CV. Differentiating both sides with respect to t, time, we will get dq by dt is equal to C into dv by dt. This will be explained in next chapter. So dq by dt, that is q by t, charge by time is current, is equal to capacitor C into dv by dt. So if dv by dt is high, this leakage current will be high. What we have thought was, the leakage current would be small because of reverse biased junction. But if the applied anode voltage is like an impact step signal, suddenly applied, this leakage current will be very high. This leakage current will be such that it will break the junction. It will break the junction J2, and then SCR will come to on state. This is also risky, so we should not apply anode voltage instantly, or some protection circuit should be made available. सो मैन्युफैक्चरर सप्लाइज डीवी बाई डी टी रेटिंग ऑफ एससीआर मीन्स द सेफ लिमिट ऑफ द एससीआर सो दैट दिस माल फंक्शन डज नॉट हैपन. ही गिव्स सपोज से एन एससीआर हैज ए डीवी बाई डी टी रेटिंग ऑफ समथिंग से 50 वोल्ट पर माइक्रो सेकेंड. इट मीन्स विद इन अ माइक्रो सेकेंड यू शुड नॉट अप्लाई एन इंक्रीमेंट और 50 वोल्ट बिटवीन द एनोड एंड कैथोड. इफ यू अप्लाई 50 वोल्ट within 1 microsecond SCR will trigger or switched on. Next is temperature triggering. What happens is the leakage current, actually the leakage current as you apply this forward voltage, the leakage current also will increase, but after some time the leakage current becomes constant. Even if you apply the voltage, it will not increase. At forward breakdown voltage, it will increase, it will break down, that is different. But this leakage current is dependent on the temperature, because as temperature increases, there will be like friction within the charge carriers. That friction will cause to release more electron hole pairs and more charge carriers, means the junction is likely to break down. So if the temperature is high, then the SCR will conduct, but that is also dangerous. The SCR will get destroyed, which is also called as thermal runaway. Hence protection circuit should be made for all these things, which we will study later. The last one is light triggering. If light falling on junction J2 is increased, that light also will cause the charge carrier's energy to increase, which will break down this junction. Provided the SCR is in forward direction, the SCR will conduct. This method is actually used in LASCR. LASCR. Light activated SCR. Like you have photo transistor, you also have photo SCR. Photo SCR is also called as LASCR. So you have usually use gate triggering and a little bit light triggering. Other methods are not employed in practice. In the two transistor analogy, in the last topic, lot more figures are given. You use only important figure what is easy for you. Now, ideal characteristics of an SCR. This is not required for examination, just giving you an idea. See, this is a forward blocking state, this is a forward conduction state, and this is reverse blocking state. Ideally, the leakage current should be zero. That means it should be along the positive side of x-axis. Once forward breakover voltage is reached, or you apply gate current, whatever it is, it will go to forward conduction state, and the voltage drop across SCR should be perfectly zero. Hence it should be y-axis. The holding current and latching current should be zero. Hence it should touch the x-axis. This is the reverse side. Again, no reverse leakage current. But what happens is, practically there will be leakage current and there will be small voltage, 0.7 voltage here. While you drawing the characteristics, note that, see, there is small bend is there. Actually, it is better to write this figure. But actually, slope is not there. This will be around 0.7 here, and here it will reach around 1 volt, 0.9 or something, 1 volt, depending on the SCR. This does not touch here due to the need of latching and holding current. See, this is a latching current. Okay, and this is the holding current. You can clearly see the latching current is higher than holding current. Holding current is this value, say 15 milliamperes. Latching current is, say, something 20 milliamperes. This all depend upon individual SCRs. It is not fixed value. Sometimes it may be 6 milliamperes and 7 milliamperes. Sometimes it may be 20 and 25, like that. But it will be milliamperes. So this is the characteristics of a practical SCR, and the other one is characteristics of ideal SCR.